Today we're going to look at app called Quizzes. It's an online app called Quizizz. And the nice thing about it is you don't have to log in to do it. You can just say get started. And it gives you different options here. Now these are all different quizzes that other people have created. Here's their username. They've made them public so people can use them. The cool thing is that if you go, say you want to do a Disney movie quiz, you go over top of it and you can see what the different questions are from. Christianity, there's all different ones. So let's look up, let's do triangles. So all these are different ones for triangles. They tell what level. This is 6 to 12. So let's look at triangle classification, isosceles triangles. Here's all the questions. But if you click on that, you actually get a deeper part here that will show you all the different ones. It also, when you create a quizzes, you can set the time limit. My suggestion is to put the time limit at the max, and the max is 15 minutes per question, because they're going to move through it quickly anyway, so you don't really have to worry about setting a 30-second, which is the minimum, up to a 15-minute. I'd go ahead and set them all 15 minutes and then let them work through as they need, because you don't want them to be cut off in the middle of a question. So I just typically set it all the questions to 15 minutes, and then they move through as they need to do it. The good thing is if with Google Classroom, you can set this as an assignment. So you can click on it and you can set it as homework, but really it's not homework. It could be a class assignment, and you can set it that way. You just click on homework, and then whenever the students get a chance, they go in, they complete it on their own time. So it's not actually being played live. But let's look at the play live. So if we click on play live, you can sign up for it to get the reports, but we're not going to do that. With our system, you would log in with Google, because it'll log you in right away with your account, which is really nice. But let's say we don't have an account. Let's just click here. And you can proceed to play that quiz right at this moment. Now, a few things. I always take and click off. I make this very simple for them. To me, too many things distract. So jumble the questions is not a bad one. If you have two people sitting side by side, you don't want them to see the same thing at the same time. So that I leave on. Jumble answers, I'm not really sure. You know, if you want to put them in different order, that's okay. Show answers, you definitely want to leave that, so they know when they did have an incorrect one what it was, and show the review. Those four I generally leave checked. These are the ones I don't, because I don't want it to be a competition. I click off of the leaderboard. I don't want, a lot of my students in the past have said that the timer makes them nervous, so I take that off. The memes to me can be silly, so I take that off. Yes, I'm no fun, sorry. And playing music again can be distracting, so I turn that off. So usually, typically, I leave all these on and turn all these off. And then you click proceed. Once you click proceed, then it waits for the students to join a game. And let me see if I can. They'll join it by using this code right here. So let me open another tab. And oops, sorry. And oops, sorry. Let's go back, join a game. So I'm like acting like the student now, and I need code 371990. 371990, and say proceed. And I need to put my name in, and I'm going to say join the game. So it gives me an avatar, and then it waiting for it to start. Now, in this one, on the teacher side, you can see where I joined in. Now, if you don't like what they joined in, the name they joined in, you can kick them out and you can make them rejoin with a proper name. So that's a good option right there. But anyway, I say start game, and then you can see on both sides it's counting down. And I'm on the student side now. And then it says, what is the value of X? And you would go through this and answer all of them. So I don't embarrass myself. I'm just going to click through. Hey, good answer. Click through. Man, I am a good guesser. And as you go through, again, you have a certain amount of time to get through all of them. And I should have picked one that wasn't 16 different answers. Because at the end of this, you do get. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause this and then I'll come back after I answer all these. Okay, so here I am on the last one. My guessing was good at the beginning, but it's not so good now. Ooh, actually, I got that one correct. So now I've done 16 out of 16. I'm all finished. It gives them a review of the different questions and which ones they missed. And then on this side, it's given the teacher a record of exactly what the student scored and how many. So you can always export this results and click here, and you get an Excel spreadsheet down at the bottom if I open that spreadsheet. In the spreadsheet, it will give you the number of correct and incorrect and the number of attempts. It will give you all the different students, and it would give you a percentage score, so you could take a grade if you wanted to from that. It's a great way to quick assess students and see which ones need more review and remediation and which ones have it. So it's a great tool to have. Okay, I'll do a second video that actually shows how you create a quiz.